Now, a while back, we talked about the potential and opportunity that animal husbandry as a branch of farming presents. So today, we again delve into where or areas that one can play into within this value chain of animal husbandry, without necessarily rearing animals, but providing something as simple as pastures.
For those people who cannot manage tractors to make bale, Africa, we have more knowledge of doing most of these things. So you can have this box. I'm going to show you briefly how it works. Within one time, you have, just shortest time, you have done your hay. Just the shortest time. And you don't need a tractor. Now, this is the box. This is the box. So you get we are feeding it. That's enough. This one it's used for it's a fan. Fan, you know. I'm making my money now. When it's full, you get these strings, you get another string, you pass it here, you get this one down. You see? You see? This is the bell I'm talking about. What does it need really? We have to first go to university to make this? No. Any person who has never gone to school, you can have this. You see? Now what is the difference between here? So are these bells, as you can see. So here there are many. Over 700 bells here. So this is it. All these are the bells. This is your coriandra. This is coriandra. This is the coriandra. We have already done it. We have already dried it. And it's here, ready for the cows to consume. Now, kasori, when you plant maize, we look more which type of maize are you planting. For example, this is yellow maize. Yellow maize has got that kind of carotene. Good for cows, for dairy, for fattening, you know. When you're doing for fattening, this is the best thing you can. And we normally plant two, three. Very high. And when we are making silage, we are going to cut everything, thereby you're benefiting. I'm telling you, when you're doing silage, it's more profitable. I repeat, silage is more profitable than someone who is doing grain. Because you're an acre of silage, you can get, say, just like 10 tons. 10 tons of silage. A ton, we sell it at 350, meaning 10, you're going to get 3.5 million. The person who is doing grain, at most they're going to give you, maybe you're going to get maybe 8 bags. The most price it has ever gone, it's 1,000, I think 200. So with 8 bags, you're going to get maybe 900, and that is chibaru. So that's why I'm encouraging people, when you're doing agriculture, you must do chibaru. You have cut your grass. After cutting it, the fresh, as we have seen, now you're going to add additives. If it is maize, because maize has got its own sugars, you don't mix any additive. But because it is Napier does not have a lot of sugars. What is the use of sugars? For fermentation process. So we are going to add, you can add molasses, you can add maize bran, you can add rice bran, all the brands you have. So we add, of recent now we are introducing the chikanja, you know. So we bring the spent grain. So you put, so that you have added more sugars, energy, so that which can be even equivalent to that one of either sorghum Oh. Now this is. This is the build. And you can hear the kawowo. You see the kawowo. This is, as I'm telling you, we added the chikanja. We cut the chifuta, which is in English, Bracharia mulatto, and we branded it. As long as it is sealed, up to 4 years, up to 5 years, up to 6 years, and it can remain here for as long as you want. So here, even if it rains, even if it shines, even if it's wind or what, it is ever. So you can have, this is half a ton, and good to go. A cow can finish like maybe 25 or 30. So you can calculate and see.
Now, we all know that it's tough sometimes to mobilize people to come and work together and push in the same direction, especially when business is in the middle. But experts are telling us that it's one way you can actually make it or move from one step to another economically. So we try to deal with group dynamics and how you can actually mobilize groups towards a business cause.
The world now is moving on the other side of group economics, okay? Now, the group economics means that we use the power of numbers, people who are around us. Now, people who are around us, you may have little money, but because we are grown up in a capitalist economy in Uganda, where you find everybody has their own little. So in that little that you have, you find it's not enough, but someone also has something little. But when it is something little to another little joined up together, I want to assure you, you can move mountains. Where you see that getting, like buying such a building, 20 billion, an individual, it will take you 30 years to do it. But in 1 year, you can raise $1 million. You find that over 500 people own this building. Then you combine efforts again and go and buy another one. Okay? So group economics can help people get rid of corruption. Group economics can help people stop the speed of yearning and looking for money aggressively. You know, when you have a family and you are like, I'm saving my 60,000, I am comfortable that at least at the end of this period, let's say you are 20 years, at the end of 20 years again, you will be 40 years, you need a home. If let's say you're 30 years, you're saving this little and you are sure that at 50 years you're going to get a home, nobody sent you for money. But just because we have these pressures from families, the little we get, we save it. So all the time you find that someone gets a job and starts stealing from people because he feels there's a family pressure. But once you know that, yes, I have little I can save, and I always tell people, save what you can. Don't save too much. Saving too much also is an austerity. You find that you're saving beyond what you're earning. Don't live below your means, don't live above your means, but live within your means. If you say that every month is something I'm saving, you're better off than somebody who doesn't save completely and also. So the group economics will move mountains. I'll give you an example. If you go to Washington, there are Eritreans. There are over 30,000 Eritreans that own about 4 or 5 streets in Washington. They save little money. You see, when you're in America, maybe you're a refugee, you're there, you have challenges. But when you get combined, just 2,000, even if you say every month you're collecting $5, it's a lot of money. $5, if you get it to 30,000 people, that's $15,000.
We're in our tech and innovation segment today. We still share with you the new innovations that are driving the business world especially, but of course touching all aspects of life, social, political, and otherwise.
So like I was telling you earlier, we built a platform that is both Android and web, and also can use SMS for the feature phones and USSD. What this means is the farmer can request for information, yeah, advisory services, pricing for the farmer, and also make transactions using the system. Yeah, so we built it in very simplistic manners that actually you can send an SMS and request for this information. The agents actually profile, even when they don't have smartphones, they can profile using USSD. USSD, I think you've seen codes, you get like *284*#, and then you find profile or register firm and stuff. So our agents use that. And those in areas, and you can't believe it, that some of our rural settings don't have internet at all, completely. And that is one of the things I would request our government to do, or our telecoms to also work with. And they have been forthcoming on trying to help on that. Now, the Hamwe platform profiles the farmer's production. If you produce one bag, we put it into the system. And then we profile the acreage you have. Most of them don't know the number of acreage. But if you brought me 5 bags, I'm assuming you planted on 1 acre. And so we sometimes assume the acreage. Then when you're planting and you're ordering for seed, our digital agents go into the field with you. They have a geolocation of where the field is. And then we start from that point on. Now, the interesting factor is, after 2 cycles of production, we actually have your statement of accounts, financial inclusion. You now can work, you can actually request for your platform and for your statement from your cooperative, and you can tell a banker that, look here. Yes. I mean, most of them didn't know that they could actually use that statement to get credit. And I'm happy we've gotten 2 financial companies, banks that are actually willing to work. Of course, I'm favored because there's, like I introduced to you earlier, there are people who have helped me there. But we have gotten over 3,000 farmers benefiting from credit only by using their farming records. It's amazing. Yeah. So we build logic that actually can accommodate, and even semi-illiterate digital agents can use the system. We just give you, like your email, you log in and then you input. We give you a location of what you can input. For example, if you're a single farmer, you can, today I'm paying for weeding, slashing, put that money into the system. Whatever you incur, the cost you incur, our app, actually you put that into the system. And at the end of it all, if you do collections, you also put it in the system. And then at the end of it all, you know that, okay, I use 700,000 and I'm making 700,000. This is crap. Then you look for ways of actually improving your agriculture sector.
Well, thank you for being part of the show. It's been a pleasure having you here. Now, from me and team, we'd like to wish you a very good evening. But then, as usual, we'd like to keep the conversation going, because business never sleeps. So let's keep discussing. Give us your feedback. Let's discuss business. Until next time, bye-bye.